But g'day guys, welcome back to another episode. Today we're doing a kids one. Just had a hell of a lot of fun chatting these guys. Mini marlin or garfish. Every summer they turn up. They love hanging off jetties and bays and marinas and breakwalls like this. And you have an absolute ball on them. Best thing is they're great to eat. Kids love them and they make a great bait as well. We're trolling for Spanish mackerel, snapper, that type of thing. The other beauty of them is you only need little light outfits. I've just got a little 2000 reel here. 4 pound line, little quill float, and the secret trick to garfish, got a size 14 long shank hook there, got a bit of bait on it. Just a size 14 or 12 long shank hook, no lead, no nothing, I'll just use some bread or a little bit of fish flesh for them. Let's go and catch some, I'll show you how you do it. Simple as that, guys. Very first cast, garfish. That's it. All there is to it. Try and go for a slightly bigger one. That's that really little mouth there I was talking about. Little wrap. Garfish. That's the problem, they don't release very well, you get all this scale coming off them. Got a couple of bigger ones though. So just a little bit of flesh bait. I like to burley with bread, but actually use bait, flesh bait. I'm not using any lead on that float, just a pencil float, like I said. Just cast her out. When they're on, it doesn't really take too long. They're on that now, see? They're caught up there, and then, oh, dropped him. Look, just to lay over two. Just trot on my bait, that was smart, wasn't it? There we go, the bite. You see your float stand up a bit and jiggle around. And bait it there. There we go. Definitely the right species, wrong size. A little bit bigger. So this is a classic Garfish environment. See here, I'm on a rock wall. You want nice calm conditions, but I'm fishing over sand here, you see, and the garries will be holding out over the sand. That's a slightly better one. You'll do it, that's a better one. There you do it, Garfish, beautiful little fish. Great baits, great to eat. We'll keep him. Guys, just get a bit of bread, I think it's a bit like that. Just sort of scrunch it up, throw it out. That'll keep me in the area. See him out there hitting that now. Knife would have helped, right? I'm just using yellowfin tuna here, but you can use any flesh bait. Filled prawns are good. Pilchards are good. Lots of guys. The only problem with garfish is that they taste so good that my missus is always stealing my troll baits, so I have to catch a few extra for her. Delicious deep. There we go, got him, food him cuz. Oh, it's a good one. He's alright, isn't he? There we go. Oh, Bob Jungle garfish. Simple as that. Oh, no, got off. Cast it off. Problem with flesh baits is like they can get a bit flaky and hard to keep on your hook, especially when you cast them. Old bait, not good. Old yucky bait. Of course you can use just bread too, so just roll it up into a small ball like that. Like that. Thank you. I just let that float lie flat, no lead like I said before, and it'll either stand up or you'll just see it dart off. You know Gary's playing with it. They can be pretty finicky with that really small mouth, hard to get the hook into. That's it. Oh, floating cuz. Sometimes you can do a real slow wind, that might help you hook them up a little bit. But they're biting pretty good today, so I'm just letting them take the float like that. Got that one. Oh, see, quite easy to pull the hook on them, eh? I think you want a real small bit of bread, eh? Not too big. That just helps you hook them. We're about due to stick one here, come on. Robert, you can do it. There we go. Oh, frustrating, huh? That's cool. That's a better one.
One last car, hang on. Okay, last car.